I call this meeting of the Northeast Independent School District to order. Let the record show that a quorum of board members is present, that this meeting has been duly called, and that notice of this meeting has been posted in accordance with the Texas Open Meetings Act, Texas Government Code Chapter 551. The board will now adjourn into executive session pursuant to the following sections of the Texas Open Meetings Act. Texas Government Code Section 551.071, private consultation with the board's attorney, 551.072, discussing purchase, exchange, lease, or value of real property, 551.074, to discuss personnel or to hear complaints against personnel, and the time is 5:32. The board will now reconvene into open session. The time is 6:30. On behalf of the trustees, I would like to welcome you to this evening's meeting of the Northeast Independent School Board. This is a business meeting of the board held in public. We appreciate your attendance and request your respectful attention. We welcome your comments during the matters from the floor section of the agenda. If you signed up to address a specific action agenda item, you will be called at that time. Finally, I would like to remind you that it is the mission of Northeast to challenge and encourage each student to achieve and demonstrate academic excellence, technical skills, and responsible citizenship. Item 5, Invocation and Pledge of Allegiance. Madison High School, Mr. Zimmerman.
Good evening, Madam President, board members, Dr. Gottardy, members of the executive staff, and guests. I bring you greetings from Madison High School, the home of the Mighty Mavericks. I would like to introduce you to two students who I believe are a great representation of the Madison community, Isabella and Angelina Rodriguez, and they are here with they are the daughters of Elsa and Jimmy Rodriguez. The Madison community is one with deep roots, and this family is a shining example of how our families send not only one, but multiple students to our campuses. Isabella is a senior, while Angelina is a freshman this year. Both of these young women represent the 360-degree student of Northeast ISD. Isabella has been involved in volleyball and choir all 4 years, and most recently was the lead in our school musical production of Guys and Dolls. She is a member of the Madison National Honor Society and our senior class secretary. Isabella was also a member of our junior corps, as well as a current member of the Madison Girl Up Club. Isabella will graduate magna cum laude in June and plans to attend Texas State in the fall. Angelina, while only in her first year of high school, is also very involved at Madison. Angelina was a member of our varsity volleyball team as a freshman and also the Madison Choir. And I have no doubt that Angelina will only add to her resume as she continues in her time at Madison. In addition to these school accolades, Isabella and Angelina are also very involved in giving back to the community. The girls help with numerous organizations to assist with church activities and local food banks. Isabella will be giving our invocation tonight, and Angelina will follow with the pledge.
Dear Father, we thank you for everyone gathered here now. Thank you for knowing each one of us by name and allowing us to walk with you. As we begin this meeting, we ask that you would guide our thoughts and our actions so we can have a successful gathering today. We meet to serve our community, to use our resources wisely, to represent all members of our community fairly, and to make decisions that promote the common good. Please bless each and every one of us this evening. Thank you. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, and one with liberty and justice for all. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state under God, one and indivisible.
Yes. Thank you, Isabella and Angelina. Would you please come forward? We'd like to take some pictures, and we have a certificate for you Mrs. Winkley's going to give you. Who's this from? Oh, it's already on. I don't know that I'm going to do about that. I want to thank you for being here, and you are welcome to go. You're welcome to stay, but I'm sure you have a lot of homework and activities that you would like to do, so thank you so much for being here. We appreciate it. Item 5, matters from executive session. A, personnel including but not limited to administrative appointments pursuant to Government Code Section 551.074. 1, possible action regarding routine personnel including but not limited to administrative appointments. Do I have a motion to approve as discussed in executive session?
So moved.
Thank you, Mr. Hawson. Do I have a second?
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Trevino. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion carries. Item 2, introductions. Dr. Gottardy.
Thank you, Madam President, board members, ladies and gentlemen. We have quite a few introductions tonight. I would love to start with many of the Boy Scouts that are in the audience here this evening. So if I could have, let's see here. We have Boy Scouts from Nimitz Middle School, Troop 63. We have with us Juan Pablo Sasata. There's Juan. He's in the sixth grade. We have Lance Bocas, who's in the seventh grade. And Davian Rios, who's in the seventh grade. How about a round of applause for these young men? They are all working on their citizenship in the community badge. Thank you, fellas, for being here this evening. We have with us, with those guys, we have with us troop leader Miguel Sasata. Must be father. Thank you for being with us. And we have an assistant, Jade Mindertsma. Where's Jade? There's Jade. Thank you, Jade, for being here. We certainly appreciate y'all being with us this evening. Thank you. Okay, so we have some introductions. We have a brand new principal of Bradley Middle School, Mrs. Brenda Cerrone. Brenda, if you'll please stand. Brenda, I'm sorry, I should have said, will you please stand while I give your introduction here. Brenda joined the Northeast family in 1996. Prior to being named principal at Bradley, she was an assistant principal at Reagan High School. Ms. Cerrone received a bachelor's degree in interdisciplinary studies in 1993 from the University of Texas at San Antonio. She earned a master's degree in educational leadership and policy studies in 2012 from the University of Texas at San Antonio. Ms. Cerrone has 24 years in education. Congratulations, Brenda. We have a brand new principal of our pre-K academy at West Avenue Elementary School, Mr. Paul Kinlan. Paul is joining the Northeast family as a principal at pre-K academy at West Avenue Elementary School. Before joining Northeast, he was the assistant director at pre-K for SA. Mr. Kinlan received a bachelor's degree in Spanish in 1993 from St. John's University and earned a master's degree in educational management and development in 2002 from New Mexico State University. Mr. Kinlan has 21 years in education. Paul, congratulations and welcome back to Northeast Independent School District. A new assistant principal at Johnson High School, Ms. Candace Pearson. There she is. Candace joined the Northeast family in 2006. Prior to being named assistant principal at Johnson, she was an assistant principal at Bush Middle School. Ms. Pearson received a bachelor's degree in human resources management in 2003 from Baylor University. She earned a master's degree in educational administration in 2013 from Texas A&M University. And Candace has 12 years in education. Congratulations, Candace. We have a new assistant principal of Thousand Oaks Elementary School, Terri Click. There's Terri. Terri joined the Northeast family in 2015. Prior to being named assistant principal at Thousand Oaks, he was a teacher at Windcrest Elementary School. Mr. Click received a bachelor's degree in elementary ed in 2013 from the University of Texas at San Antonio. He earned a master's degree in educational leadership in 2017 from the University of Texas, San Antonio. Mr. Click has 5 years in education. Congratulations, Terri. We have a new assistant principal of Madison High School, Wolanda Whitaker. Ms. Whitaker joined the Northeast family in 2010. Prior to being named assistant principal at Madison High School, she was a teacher at Madison High School. Ms. Whitaker received a bachelor's degree in biology in 2004 from the University of Texas at San Antonio. She earned a master's degree in education in 2007 from the University of Texas at San Antonio and a second master's degree in leadership and educational administration in 2012 from Capella University. Ms. Whitaker has 13 years in education. Congratulations, Wolanda. We have a new assistant principal of Reagan High School, Ms. Jennifer Esparza. Jennifer joined the Northeast family in 2004. Prior to being named assistant principal at Reagan, she was a teacher at Reagan High School. Ms. Esparza received a bachelor's degree in Spanish in 1999 from Hardin-Simmons University. She earned a master's degree in counseling and human development in 2002 from Hardin-Simmons University as well. Ms. Esparza has 19 years in education. Congratulations and welcome, Jennifer. That concludes our introductions. Thank you, Madam President.
It concludes your introductions. I would like to introduce our newest board member to David Beyer. He replaced Mr. Wheat, who had to resign due to taking a position as an associate judge. So we are very excited that Mr. Beyer has joined our team, and we look forward to working with him. And since this is his first regular board meeting, I wanted to introduce him to everyone. And it's not really an introduction, but I would like to congratulate Dr. Gottardy and Ms. Shore. I don't see her. They received PTA awards from Council PTA last Thursday night at the Founders Day, which was very exciting. So I just wanted to congratulate them again in front of our group. Item B, possible action on the purchase, exchange, lease, or value of real property pursuant to Government Code Section 551.072, no action. C, possible action regarding consultation with board's attorney pursuant to Government Code Section 551.071. 1, pending and or possible litigation, no action. 7, recognitions. A, 2018 National FFA Agriscience Fair. Dr. Newman.
Thank you, President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff, and guests. At this time, I would like to ask Doak Stewart, our director for the Agriscience Magnet Program, to address this item.
Good evening, President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, our executive staff, as well as our guest. And I want to say howdy from the Agriscience Magnet Program this evening.
Howdy.
Tonight, I'd like to introduce to everyone I'm going to do actually three young ladies, but first up, we're going to have, share with you and introduce to you two of those that recently competed for and received the national title within their division at the 91st National FFA Convention. And I'd like to introduce at this time Ms. Hannah Taylor, who's a 12th grader with us there in the Agriscience Magnet Program in Madison High School, and she's joined by her father, Alex Taylor. And then also Ms. Ashley Walker, who is, she did her studies in 3 years of high school, and it was an early graduate, and is now already in her second semester at UTSA. And she is joined by her mother, Jill Walker. These young ladies, y'all might have maybe seen some of their story back in September when a marketing group by the name of Power Group picked up their story about their potential patent that they have on a new invention that they've created. And that actually ran in Express News, KSAT, Ken's TV, and so forth, and was carried all across the country. Ashley and Hannah competed with their Agriscience Fair research project titled The Effects of Aeration in Regards to Lifespan and Bacteria Present of Lilium Orientalis. Did I get close, ladies? Okay. This was one of 21 projects from all across the United States that were invited to come compete in their division of the plant science category at the 91st National FFA Convention. They bested their competition and they won the title National FFA Agriscience Fair Champion. And they were coached and advised by Mr. Joshua Anderson. And so I want to give them congratulations on such a feat. So Ms. Hannah and Ashley. And I also would like to take this time, go ahead and want like me to go into the next action on that as well with the...
Well, could we take photos with
well,
young,
more
those
than
young
welcome.
Ladies?
Yes. This, okay, so if y'all would, come on up forward and we will get a certificate and a photo.
Congratulations.
All right.
Go ahead. Sorry.
All right. Thank you. And now at this time, I'd like to introduce to you Miss Alicia Montemayor. She is a 12th grader there at Madison High School and a member of our James Madison FFA. And she's joined by her parents, Mario and Michelle Montemayor. And Alicia was named the national champion with her poultry production agriculture proficiency. She has a very large poultry project program that she actually raises there at the school and in her backyard in Castle Hills area. So I hope I didn't give away any secrets there. She's actually sought out by many people throughout the state of Texas and across the country that buy stock from her for their own farms, and so she has done a great job, and that really catapulted her to the top of the competition this year. She was one of only four students from across the United States, Puerto Rico, and the Virgin Islands that actually received an invite to come interview at the National FFA Convention this year, and of course she walked away with the top award, and we're very proud of her. And she was coached by Mr. Tyler Price. So Miss Alicia Montemayor.
Yes, please come forward. Congratulations. I failed to mention that was the FFA agricultural proficiency, but we're finished with that, right? Okay, thank you. I apologize about that. Item C, Reagan Wind Ensemble, Dr. Newman.
Thank you, President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff and guests. At this time, Julie Shore, our executive director for fine arts and student activities, will introduce this fine group of students.
Good evening. I have the privilege of introducing you to some very talented and accomplished wind ensemble students from Reagan High School. These students were selected to perform at the Midwest Clinic International Band and Orchestra Conference in Chicago, which was the highest achievement possible for a high school concert band. Only one other band from San Antonio has ever been accepted to perform in its 72-year history, and that was back in 1982. There were over 2,500 people in attendance at this concert from all over the world. The Wind Ensemble performed four world premieres written by famous professional composers who were also in attendance at the concert. The Wind Ensemble was honored with a special guest performer, Wayne Bergeron, a highly regarded professional trumpet player from LA. He can be heard on several movies and TV shows and soundtracks, including things like The Incredibles, La La Land, Frozen, Family Guy, Toy Story. I mean, I could go on a lot. It's hundreds more. This was an incredible opportunity for our Reagan students and also for our school district. So without further delay, I would like to introduce you to these wonderful students and their director. Ariana Chavez. Lexi Davis. Crystal Galindo.
Congratulations.
Kinley Hatch. Sarah Rudolph. Mackenzie Tupper. Zaid Varani. Joyce Ha. This student couldn't be with us this evening, but I'd like to say her name, Abby Hamilton. Catherine Hansen. Matthew Hernandez. Logan Lehman. Alexis Ponsetti. Alyssa Bird. Matthew Fine. Connor Foster. Matthew Hill. Jessica McDonald. Ashley Morellis. Lily C. Emily Salcaron. Nathan Diaz. Andreas Gonzalez. Adriana Lopez Bohr. Jacob Brockett. Bennett Kumbelick. Samir Mahedo. James Pechakara. Alex Paulino. Bennett Tiller. James Zhang. Andy Lee. Grace Giles. Haley Anderson. Nico Bonaccini. Alina Fisher. Jonas Guzman. Tyler Lowry. Joe Napier. Zach Reynolds. Josh Robbins. Ian Uriguez. Hannah Watson. Avery Darjlik. Yvonne Seabee. Lauren Myatt. Matthew Hockley. Nicole Abel. Sarah Napier. Spencer Landon. Garrett Arnold. Andrew Brown. Markham Brown. Benson Meadows. Keenan Turner. Mason Vetter. Ashley Ortega. Chris Shanks. The next student couldn't join us this evening, but I would like to say her name, Mariah Dorman. Emma Pohl. Olga Tumanova. Brandon Butler, Zach Doherty, Carter Duggins, Dominic Galliano, Alejandro Paredes, Dawson Rice, Lexi Wilder, and the director of this magnificent group is the one and only Mr. Dan Morrison. I'd also like to take a second and introduce our director of music programs, Mr. Jody Noblet, as well. And we're going to take a picture of you guys, so we're going to try to squish in as much as possible. And parents, you're welcome to come up and take pictures. You can come all the way up to the front. You don't have to hide in the back. I'm done. Yes, ma'am, of course. You want me to make them stay? Is that what you're saying? You want me to make them stay after their picture so you can talk to them? Okay. I'll get out of your way. Isn't this a really great problem to have? Pretty nice.
I don't want y'all to leave because I want to talk to you, and I came to the front so that I could see your faces and not talk to your back. But y'all are welcome to still take pictures. Dr. Gottardy and I had the privilege of going to Chicago to see you. I knew it was a big deal, but I didn't understand what a big deal it was. I was blown away. I heard while we were there that if you had the Friday noon performance, it was the prime performance to be able to perform at, and it was evidence when you look in this ballroom of 2,500 people, standing room only. I was nervous, and I wasn't performing. You guys were amazing. You acted like you were just up there playing, and there was nobody out there. I mean, I was just blown away, and then I jumped on stage afterwards and interrupted Mr. Morrison, because I wanted to tell you how proud I was, and I couldn't speak because I was so choked up and overwhelmed. You guys just were amazing. Mr. Morrison, you were amazing. The talent of the composers and the guest that you had up there conducting with you, it was so special to have your dad do that with you. And just as a mom, I'm just so proud of you. I know you guys work so hard. Like I told the Johnson Band a couple of years ago, you work hard. No, hey, sorry. I'm allowed to speak to other people. What I told the Johnson Band was those students work harder than athletes. And I truly believe that. You guys work harder than athletes. Your determination and the amount of time that you put in to do this is just, because I know you're not, you know, doing nothing else. I know you're taking AP classes. I know you're involved in other activities and other clubs, and service projects and all those things. So just the amount of time and dedication that you devote to this program is outstanding, Mr. Morrison, outstanding. Parents, thank you for your support, because I know it takes a lot of time away from your family for them to be able to do this, but we truly appreciate you giving us your children to participate in this wonderful program. And hopefully, I'm hoping, I'll be in New York to see the Macy's Day Parade, but we'll see. Thank you again and congratulations.
Going to make everybody in the back move up to the front. Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes. You're board member.
The room looks empty now.
I know. Thank you, President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff, and guests. I'd like to ask Rachel Naylor, our director for PE Health and Athletics, to talk about our PE showcase.
Miss Worldwide, let's celebrate. If you know me, then you know where to find me. Off in the Bahamas with a bad one behind me. Now live it up, live it up, live it up. Baby, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. And we gon'
boom, boom, all around the world. Boom, boom, go get it, girl. Boom, boom, that's the way we like to play. Yeah, yeah. We gon' boom, boom, all around the world. Boom, boom, go get it, girl. Boom, boom, that's the way we like to play.
Good evening, Madam President, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff, and guests. Every year, a group of elementary physical educators prepare their students for Elementary Showcase of Stars. This March will mark our 28th showcase. Our 46 elementary campuses are on a three-year rotation. This year, on the evenings of March 6th and 7th, kindergarten through fifth grade students from 14 elementary schools will dazzle over 6,500 attendees. The students showcase their skills in their physical education classes through well-rehearsed and orchestrated routines. The most amazing aspect of elementary showcase is difficult to explain, but awesome to see. Schools will perform each of the 12 routines in sync, having never practiced together as a group. The elementary physical education teachers have worked together to ensure that each routine is designed and cued the same, so when the students practice their routines on their campuses, the same product will occur on the night of showcase. This year's theme is Blast from the Past. I think you will agree from watching that video, our students are pretty amazing. Tonight, we have students from Belverde Creek, El Dorado Elementary, and Northwood Elementary to help deliver invitations. Bryn Breyer, fifth grade, from Northwood Elementary. She is accompanied by her parents, Brett and David Breyer, who didn't have a choice of being here. We have Grace Lutz, fifth grade, Northwood Elementary, and she is accompanied by her mom, Lori Lutz. We have Sarah Stuckey, Elias Stuckey, and Levi Stuckey from Belverde Creek, accompanied with their parents, Lindsay and Jason Stuckey. And then we have the Martinez family, Nathan, Sarah, and James from El Dorado Elementary, that are here with their mom, Stella Martinez. And I could not have done any of this without their PE teachers, Brandon Turner and Danielle Norman from El Dorado, Tabitha Hallman from Belverde Creek, Nympha Salinas from Northwood Elementary, and Diane Blackwood, who was going to have kids here, they're from Wilderness Oak, but flu has struck their school, and all three were unable to attend. But she is still here and smiling. We hope that you will join us on March 6th through 7th, and we hope that you will come and check out these little kiddos, plus 1,900 of their closest friends. Thank you very much.
Will y'all stay here where we want to get a picture?
And one point I want to make is the two from Northwood are one quarter of my YMCA basketball team. Oh. So.
Yes. Thank you all for being here. Item 9, new business for possible board action. A, resolutions. 1, possible action regarding rodeo day. Dr. Maika.
Thank you, President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff, and guests. I ask that Doak Stewart return to the podium for this item.
Well, thank you. Yes, I'm back. President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, members of the executive staff, and guests. The Agri-Science Magnet Program at James Madison High School, as you know, employs a three-part model of education that consists of classroom instruction, supervised agricultural experiences, and the FFA. Within the FFA, which is the youth leadership component of the AMP, efforts are focused on developing students in premier leadership, personal growth, and career success. Now, throughout the 42-year history of the James Madison FFA chapter, it has enjoyed a great relationship as a benefactor of the San Antonio Livestock Exposition through in-kind gifts, endowments, and substantial funding of scholarships for our FFA members. Because of that relationship, it is our distinct honor and privilege that the James Madison FFA chapter present the following resolution. At this time, I want to introduce you to Ms. Haley Carlisle, President of the James Madison FFA chapter, to present the resolution to the board for your consideration and action.
Good evening. My name is Haley Carlisle, a soon-to-be graduating senior of the Agri-Science Magnet Program at James Madison High School and a member of the Fightin' Texas Aggies class of 2023.
Whoop!
For the past 4 years, I have been studying agribusiness through the AMP, and I'm a very active member in the FFA with participation in leadership and career development events, agri-science fair research, the raising of breeding and market swine, and currently serving as the 2018-2019 James Madison FFA chapter president. It is a distinct honor and privilege to present the following resolution. Resolution, recognition of Northeast Independent School District Rodeo Day. Whereas the over 6,000 volunteers of the San Antonio Livestock Exposition, or SAIL, continue to provide a rich tradition and history of stewardship to the community, agricultural industry, and youth of Texas, and whereas the SAIL has grown to be one of the largest and most prestigious single events in San Antonio, providing over 1 million visitors with wholesome family entertainment and education that celebrates agricultural literacy and appreciation of the Western lifestyle. Whereas since 1950, the SAIL educational commitment exceeds $198 million, with $12 million committed in 2018 in the form of scholarships, grants, endowments, auctions, calf scramble program, and show premiums paid to the youth. Whereas to date, the SAIL has awarded $767,000 in scholarships to graduating seniors of the James Madison FFA to study agriculture at the post-secondary level. Whereas the SAIL has donated equipment and provided co-curricular activities, including career development events, school tours, and the world's largest livestock show for the students of the Northeast Independent School District. It is respectfully requested that the members of the Board of Trustees of Northeast Independent School District proclaim February 15th, 2019 as Rodeo Day.
Thank you, Haley.
Great job.
Great job. Do I have a motion to approve the resolution proclaiming February 15th, 2019 as Rodeo Day for Northeast Independent Schools?
So moved.
Thank you, Mrs. Winkley. Do I have a second?
Second.
Thank you, Mr. Trevino. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? The motion carries. Thank you again, Haley. It was a great job. Thank you, Deb. Item two, possible action regarding Career and Technical Education Month. Dr. Maika.
Thank you, President Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff, and guests. I would ask Ben Peterson, our senior director for Career and Technical Education, to come and address this item.
Hello.
Hello.
Madam President, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff, and guests. February 1st through 28th, 2019 has been designated as Career and Technical Education Month by the National Association for CTE, Career and Technical Education. CTE students study and prepare for a wide range of careers. These careers may require varying levels of education from high school to 2 and 4 year college degrees and or career specific certifications or licensures. CTE students are prepared to be a part of a well-educated workforce. Through cooperative efforts between CTE programs and business and industry, students seek lifelong skills and are being prepared for career fields to stimulate growth and vitality to our local workforce and economy. I would like to share some of our CTE accomplishments in this last school year. Each year, CTE courses provide thousands of industry-based certifications at no cost to our students. Last year alone, NEISD students earned 2,875 industry-based certifications, and this year our goal is to reach 3,000. From accounting to welding, from culinary to engineering, NEISD offers approximately 150 CTE courses that provide an opportunity for students to explore their interests and connect knowledge gained from their core coursework to real-world application. There are many student clubs and organizations, like FFA, that allow our students to compete within their coursework at the local, state, and national levels. Last year, NEISD sent 247 students to state competition, with 108 of those students advancing to national competition. We are gearing up for state competition already, and we plan to send more students this year than ever before. And you may have seen on the website today that NEISD sent over 500 students to Job Shadow Day this year, mm-hmm. where students were able to connect with and work alongside industry partners. So whether students are planning to attend college or go directly into the workforce, CTE courses provide pathways that allow for students to attain meaningful and gainful employment upon high school graduation. Therefore, I respectfully ask that the board approve our resolution and that means February is CTE month.
Thank you, Mr. Peterson. Do I have a motion to approve the resolution recognizing the month of February as Career and Technical Education Month?
So moved.
Thank you, Mrs. Hughey. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mr. Jaso. All those in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, the motion carries. Thank you again, Ben. Item B, consent. One, instruction and campus administration. A, school health advisory council SHAC annual report. Two, business services. A, budget amendment number 3. B, 50,000 purchases. Three, operations. A, 2019 annual construction prevailing wage rates approval for Northeast ISD construction programs. B, M&O program, Las Lomas and Vineyard Ranch Elementary School, Central Energy Plant, Chemical Water Treatment Service Contracts, Bid Award Approval. C, Professional Service Contracts, Construction Contracts, and Related Contract Amendments supporting the 2015 Bond Design and Construction Requirements. 4 minutes from December 2018. 5, end of consent. Do I have a board member wishing to pull an item from consent? Seeing none, do I have a motion to approve consent as presented?
So moved.
Thank you, Mrs. Winkley. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
Thank you, Mr. Jaso. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, the motion carries. Item 10, reports. A, second quarter investment report. That's been provided for you. B, financial statement review of expenditures. That's been provided for you. C, awarded bid report. That's been provided for you. 11, matters from the floor. The trustees welcome comments from members of the public during this time of the meeting. Generally, board members do not respond to public comments during the meeting, although members may request further information or a future agenda item on a matter raised during public comment. As explained fully in the board's written procedures for this time, the matters from the floor portion is a limited public forum. Accordingly, speakers may present on a topic related to district business for up to 3 minutes, but are not permitted to make one, personal complaints about an individual staff or board member that should be raised using the district's grievance policies. Two, a personnel action. Three, a student disciplinary matter. Four, a complaint about a particular student. Five, or pending litigation. Any person who persists in speaking on these topics after being directed not to do so will lose the remainder of their time to speak and may lose their privilege of addressing the board at future meetings. We also welcome written comments at any time, either through email at board@neisd.net or by mail care of the superintendent's office at 8961 Tesoro Drive, 6th floor, San Antonio, Texas, 78217. Ms. Hughey.
Patsy Esterline.
This went by faster than we thought it did. Anyway, good evening, Ms. Grona, members of the board, Dr. Gottardy, executive staff. My name is Patsy Esterline. I live at 8603 Glenmont, G-L-E-N, capital M-O-N-T, San Antonio, Texas, 78239. Yes, I finally moved back into Northeast. Okay. I know Tom always likes us to use the office address, but I just thought I'd throw that in. And I'm the president of the Northeast AFT. Mr. Beyer, on behalf of the members of Northeast AFT, I'd like to congratulate you on your appointment to the NEISD Board of Trustees. It's an important and challenging responsibility to represent the interests of students, employees, and taxpayers of District 4, as well as the entire district. We represent NEISD teachers and support personnel, and we look forward to working with you. I would like to report on our progress regarding First Book. Through the partnership of NEISD, First Book, and Northeast AFT, we will be delivering 40,000 books at no charge to students, teachers, and librarians in our 24 Title I schools. To do this, we must have 2,000 employees in Title I schools sign up for First Book. We're at 1,600 now, so we are almost there, thanks to the support of the Northeast Administration. These are quality books at all reading levels, with an estimated retail value of $500,000. Currently, we are looking at a distribution date of March the 23rd. There was a recent 20-year research study of the effect of the number of books in a home and student achievement. To quote the abstract, children growing up in homes with many books get 3 years more schooling than children from bookless homes, independent of their parents' education, occupation, and class. This is as great an advantage as having university educated rather than unschooled parents, and twice the advantage of having a professional rather than an unschooled father. End quote. To us, this is a perfect supplement to gain academic achievement in our Title I schools. We hope that you can come by when the books are distributed. And I'm so excited, I'm about to spontaneously combust. So, or combust. Thank you.
Thank you. Item 12, discussion and possible action regarding board members' requests for items to be placed on a future agenda and our request for reports from the administration. Does the board member have anything? Seeing none, item 13, adjournment, and the time is 7:20. Thank you all for being here. Patsy, thanks for all your work on that.